life. I am the way, the truth, and the life. Whatever you need, God's got it. Oh, we ought to take a praise break for about 30 seconds. Wherever you came from, God brought you out of. Wherever you're getting ready to go, God is getting ready to take you. Where you are right now, God is going to keep you and protect you and provide for you. You have trust in Him. No, no, the road is not going to be smooth. The road is not going to be without trials. The road is not going to be without mistakes. The road is not going to be without failures. But I'd rather have failures and be with God than be without God and have total success and never make no mistakes. How many of you know your wealth is in Jesus? That's where it is. That's where your success is. That's where your victory is. It's in Him. And when you're allowing the devil to beat you down, when I'm trying to pick you up, you're listening to every voice imaginable except for my voice. Jesus said, it's me. I want you to listen to it. Don't listen to the haters. Don't listen to the naysayers. Don't listen to those telling you you can't when I told you you can. Don't listen to the devil telling you you're dead when I said you've got life. Stop walking in defeat. Walk in victory. Listen to the wrong voices.
That's it.
We've all sinned and fall short of the glory of God. Oh, I know it comes as a surprise. I thought I was sinless, but I'm sorry to disappoint you. Anybody you listen to, anybody you take advice from, has sinned. Jesus is the only who has not sinned. And when you pray to God, when you pray in the name of Jesus, you have a filter that is without debris. And you have a trust factor that you can depend on. That when you're looking for direction, Jesus is the way. Jesus is the way. Wait a minute, I'm not sure you're getting it. I gotta break it down a little bit better. I'm not sure you're getting it, because it sounds good, but it's not connecting to you. I can feel it, I can feel you. There's a difference between maps and Uber. Now, there are a lot of great maps. Anybody who uses apps, and you can barely function today without technology, they got Waze. I love Waze because it really gives you some real-time stuff. I like Google Maps because it'll give you traffic and real-time, up-to-date from a satellite. I love it. I like whatever the map is on the iPhone because it just pulls up. You can just punch an address in and it'll come right up. And usually maps gives you great directions. Siri should tell you where to go, turn right, turn left. Turn here. No, I told you to turn here. I got a black Siri. She said, Negro, you went the wrong way. I told you. You can make Siri any way you want. Maps will give you step-by-step directions to how to get there. And brothers and sisters, in life, we need direction. You gotta have instruction on how to get somewhere. Jesus is saying, I'm not that. Hey, Pastor, you just sound like you were making a good point, but now you threw me for a loop. No, Jesus said, I'm not a map. When I say I'm the way, I'm not a map that gives you directions. Watch this. I'm the Uber that will take you there. When you call out Uber, you don't pay a fee, and then they give you directions on the phone. No, you pay a fee, and then Uber shows up.
Come on.
You get in, and they take you there. Can I tell you a little secret about victory? You gotta begin to look at Jesus not as the one who gives direction. He's the one who's gonna take you there in the first place. As soon as you hop in the car with Jesus, you're headed in the right direction. Some of us are busy looking at maps. And we need a relationship with the one who can take you there. Jesus is going to take you there. You need a degree in many instances. You need a degree in many instances. But ultimately, you need a relationship with Jesus. Because your degree can't take you where Jesus wants to take you. You need money. You need money every day. There's very little you can do without money. Matter of fact, I was in the Uber yesterday with the Uber driver, and I asked him, was he a Christian? We started talking about Christ, and he said, well, Church is just turning into a business nowadays. I don't like church anymore. I said, well, what do you mean, brother? He said, it's just big business. It's just all about money. I said, well, there's very little you can do in life without money. He said, yeah, but it's changing. I said, it's always been. I said, you can't keep the lights on without money. I said, why is it that in every facet of life, we understand it takes money to live, but in the church, we think it don't? I'm just speaking from practical sense. Spiritually, we know Jesus runs this thing. Spiritually, we know Jesus is the one who holds the keys of heaven and hell in his hands. But ultimately, to keep these on, you got to pay the light bill. Amen. Period. We cannot march down to IPL and pray on the steps and they eliminate our light bill. It ain't gonna happen. I know y'all love Jesus, but we need y'all to pay the bill. Can't focus only on money, because there's some stuff money just can't buy. And what money cannot buy, Jesus has to give it to you. Money can't buy you a good night's sleep. Money can't give you peace. Money can't give you joy. Money can temporarily fix what you got going on, but it's Jesus who will ultimately sustain you. That will never change. Jesus never sleeps nor slumbers. The word says God never sleeps nor slumbers. Now I know somebody's arguing with me right now, but Pastor, I thought he was asleep on the boat. It's a metaphor.
Right.
He had to sleep physically because he did get tired. But what Jesus is talking, what God is talking about is, I don't sleep on your needs.
Yourself
and keep on walking by faith, and God God will continue to bless you and to transform you. Fear of failure. You live your entire life, and you think it's all right for you to sit there and not be successful. You think it's all right to keep giving the testimony. Well, you know, others have all that. I don't need all that. I don't want all that. But you're mine. You know, I'm happy for people who got a nice car. I'm just putting, I got a hole in my muffler, but I don't need all that.
Sabotaging.
Sabotaging your own life.
That's it.
I see people getting nice jobs. I don't need all that. I don't need a good picture.
Come on, teach your pastor.
That doesn't sound right, does it? Nope. I don't even need a job. I'm good. Yes, you do, girl. You do. We're afraid of success, and some of us, either it's because we feel unworthy of the success, or we're just plain lazy. Because you think in your spirituality, God is just supposed to drop down a blessing. Just going to drop down a few million dollars on you, and you don't have to do anything to get it. God is just going to drop a house down, and you don't have to do anything to get it. God is just going to drop a relationship and drop the right person. You have to do nothing to work on yourself. That's a lazy spirituality. And it's dangerous because we think God is supposed to just do everything for us, and we have no responsibility in our faith to do anything. That's not true. Faith without works is dead. Amen. Y'all know the word. Faith without works is dead. Hard work. There's no substitute for it. There's been with the difference between living and having life. Life is this. When I got Jesus, the money I do have, the material I do have, I'm more blessed because I got the money and I got Jesus. But even if I don't have the money, I still got Jesus. And as long as I got King Jesus, I don't need nothing else. Is there anybody here who knows that Jesus is the center of your joy? Jesus is the center of your focus. Jesus gives you life. He gives life. Living is just in the world, but you're going to live and die and have nothing to show for it. Christ gives us life. I want to close on this because I am so proud of the Pacers. I don't know what to do. Pacers, they ain't playing around with no LeBron James. Who is LeBron James? You're in Indiana. I love it. But here's what I love about the Pacers. They came back to win the other night from a 17-point deficit. Who beats the Cavaliers? Who beats LeBron James behind 17 points? It rarely happens. But the Pacers did it. You want to know how they did it? Number one, they play to win. They don't play not to lose. See, there's a difference in life. When you live life to win it, it means you won't get victory. It doesn't mean you wait to have a failure. You don't even have failure in your mind. Losing is not even in your mind. You walk by faith and not by sight. And you say, I've got victory. Number two, how did they do it? They believe they will win. When you see the Pacers come on the floor, they looking mean too. Lance Stephenson, he looking like this. I don't care about you, LeBron. I'm a chicken, yo. Come on, LeBron. You come through here, you're gonna catch an elbow, LeBron. And brothers and sisters, if you're gonna walk in victory, you gotta believe you've got the victory. Does anybody believe you've got the victory? Do you believe God can bless you? Do you believe God can open the door? Do you believe Jesus is the source of your joy? Jesus is your victory. But last but not least, you want to know how they're winning? They come and they play to win. transformation. Jesus is your victory. Can everybody shout Jesus?
Jesus.
Can everybody shout the name of Jesus? Jesus. Oh, let's just shout Jesus. Yeah. The name is Jesus.